Okay, if you're using Google Sheets and you have two dates and you want to count the number of work days in between them, there's a couple functions that you can use to do it, and you can just use two dates and that's all. But if you want to get more advanced, we can also look at excluding holidays and even defining which days are your weekends if they're not Saturday and Sunday. We'll just start out with the easiest way. We're going to use net work days. And don't use the international one yet. That one has complexities if you don't need them, you don't want to use. And the helper text comes up and it says, first we want the start date, then give us the end date, and then optionally give us any holidays. So we'll just start by a start date, A2, and then we'll go into B2. And just close it off with the parentheses at that point, hit enter, and it's 21 days. So this is not just 21 days in between the two, but it's 21 work days. And if that's all you need to do, then you're done. Now, if you want to put the dates directly into this formula instead of using cell references, just be careful. You have to surround them with quotes, but if you have them in other cells and you're referencing them, it should work fine. So I hid a few columns here and I hid some rows we're going to look at, but I'm going to hide the other so I don't fry your eyes. Okay, and let's look at a few little bit more complicated examples. Same start date and end date, but then we defined some holidays. We're going to do this for two different formulas here. We defined some holidays. This one has one, but this one has two, three. We're not going to delve into the weekends yet. That's going to be for Network Days International. That'll be next. But let's do Network Days. And again, once a start date and the end date. And I'm actually going to zoom out so that little helper text isn't taking up the whole screen. All right. So we're going to do A3 and B3. So if you have a holiday and you just have one, just put it in a cell and reference it. 2058 days. Now, if you want to be sure that that's not counting every day, just use the days function. But be careful, the days function's backwards. It wants the end date first. So do B3 and then A3. And you can see it's going to come up with a much larger number. So that gives you a little bit of comfort that Network Days is doing what it should. If you have more than one holiday, you can reference it in range. So if you do Network Days, you can also do an array, but that's, I think, a little bit more complicated than we need for at least these examples. So A4, B4, and then just define the range. So it starts in C4, and it goes down to D5. You could also do that with your mouse. So after you typed B4 and hit a comma, then you would just go over here and highlight this area with your mouse. If I hit enter, you see it's just a couple days less than the one above. But be careful. So this is a range of several years, right? But these holidays are just specific dates. And it's not going to work if you just define it as July 4th with no date. So you'd have to repeat these holidays for every year. Let's do one more example of network days, and I'll just show you an error. Reference a cell that actually doesn't have a valid date. It's going to give you an error, a pound value error in this instance. And it says, look, network days, the second parameter expects a date, but you gave it something called tomorrow. And I don't know what that is. So you just go in here and put in the actual date. So we could just do today plus one, which would be tomorrow. Done. Wasn't that fancy. Didn't happen to work because the start date's earlier, but that's how you could get tomorrow. Okay, now if you want to do weekends, use Network Days International. So if I just start typing there, it's going to be listed down here. So it does the number of days between two dates, but then you can specify the weekends. And we don't have to do too many of these to show you what's happening with it, but I do want to show you how you do the weekends because it's kind of quirky. Because apparently throughout the world, they want to call different days weekends. New start date and end date. And then they want the weekends. So it's put in the middle. I would have expected it to be after holidays, but it's not. So just look for that. We're going to do cell E7, and I'll come back and explain what's happening in E7. And then let's just throw in a holiday for good measure. I'm going to close it off with the parentheses and hit enter. And this calculated is 2059. So that's going to be the same number because you still specify two weekends. So the parameter that you specify for the weekends, which is in cell E7, this is a string, not a number. So what that means is when I go into that cell and I double click in it, there's a grave accent character right here, which is on my keyboard, at least right to the left of the number one. And that tells Google Sheets, look, what I'm typing after this is not a number, treat it like text. And each of these spaces is a day. This is Monday, starts on Monday. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, etc. So if it's what I would consider normal weekends, it's ending in two ones. If Friday is also a weekend, change it to that. And that's all there really is to counting the number of workdays in between two dates. And I hope that was helpful. If you like this video and you want to see others like it, please subscribe in the lower right-hand corner. Thanks.